Okay guys, on this free YouTube home study course, what you're going to learn is how to do a break fall. And there are many ways to break a fall. This is one of them. To take your hand and slap both simultaneously from fingertip to the elbow, and to turn your head because you don't want to smash your nose on the floor. You smash your nose, your eyes water and they close, and visibility becomes a problem. So to protect your face, you also turn the head and you slap simultaneously, keeping the center, important areas, protected or cushioned as you fall. So when you fall like this. Now, a lot of different martial arts teaches that break fall. But in ninjutsu, the way it was taught to me, the correct way for a ninja or kanja to fall would be to sacrifice their weak hand and their strong hand, which could be holding a weapon, goes over to the top. Okay? The wrist goes over to the top of the hand so that they don't damage their strong weapon hand. So they would sacrifice their weak using the tip to tip break fall, and your strong hand goes on top right in front of your neck so that if there are thorns or sharp objects, you don't want your neck to be damaged. So you sacrifice everything right in front of the neck and you protect your strong hand, protecting the center and falling down. So it would look like this. That's the way it should be done in ninjutsu. So from here, a regular break fall and a ninjutsu break fall should be performed like that. So there are two different break falls in Nintaijutsu. For you beginners, I recommend that you try it on your knee. Do it like this, regular break fall. And the ninjutsu break fall. Okay? Hi everybody, with your free home study course, it's also very important to me that you also receive a little education. This way you'll actually understand what you're studying, and because of word association, it'll enlighten you as of why our techniques are the way they are. First of all, let me share the meanings of the term. Nintaijutsu means the way of patience and tolerance, and that's the art. So we say Nintaijutsu. That's for the Japanese to understand. Now, for Koreans, it's called I-ne-sur, which means patience and tolerance. Again, sur is also an art form. It's based off of In-sur or Ninjutsu. The term Kanja comes from Koreans reading the character, the Chinese character. And that character, when you ask a educated Korean person to pronounce the Chinese character, they will clearly say Kanja. What's also coincidental, or this is by freak accident, in Japan's history, they also use the word Kanja. Now the modern term that Koreans use for spy today is kancha. And again, by accidental or by freak of nature, the Japanese used to call their spies way back in history kancho. And as time passed in Japanese history, they called them shinobi no mono. And then what everybody recognizes as ninja today. So basically, Nintaijutsu is martial arts forms that the spies used. And this is basically what you're learning. Now, these are other terms that the ninjas were also recognized as shikaku or shage. This simply means assassin. What I do want to also mention is China had a big influence in cultural development, not only for Korea, but Japan as well. But what you're not going to find is Chinese terms used by Koreans or Japanese. They do know how to read the characters, Chinese characters, which was used all throughout Asia. What's interesting is, again, like I said, Koreans and Japanese pronounce them similar, but Chinese, they pronounce them totally different. And of course, I'm going to be called a liar for this, but the Koreans taught the Japanese how to read Chinese characters. Not only that, they've also taught them the kana system as well. As we continue in this home study course, I am going to educate you more on terms and what they are and who used them and even how to pronounce them as best I can. Mm-hmm.